This is CBS 5 Eyewitness News.
I don't want to kill nobody, but they always say
lyrics about murder and rape, fans with gory costumes. Tonight, we take you inside Horrorcore. Good evening, I'm Ken Bastida. This is a style of hardcore rap that takes horror to a whole new level. But some fans seem to take the music message a little too far. Joe Vasquez tonight with a closer look at the music linked to a string of recent murders.
Friday the 13th in San Francisco, the insane clown posse is in town. These horrorcore fans, who call themselves Juggalos, are lined up by the hundreds in colorful, creepy, sometimes bloody costumes.
Who are you guys?
We are individuals, Juggalos and Juggalettes. I'm feeling crazy, sad,
hazy, so hide your baby. Inside, the opening act is Mars, a Bay Area native and a star in the music genre of horrorcore. You may remember we talked to him in September after a Bay Area horrorcore fan nicknamed Psycho Sam was arrested for killing four people in Virginia. Since that time, another gruesome murder. Last month in New Hampshire, four teenagers were arrested for hacking a woman to death with a machete. Her 11-year-old daughter survived the attack. The lead suspect was wearing a horrorcore t-shirt when he was arrested. On his MySpace page, he called himself a Juggalo for life.
Every time I turn the music up, I get evil. It's telling me to go right out to kill people.
Horrorcore focuses on murder, mayhem, and rape. The over-the-top lyrics led Rolling Stone magazine to call the music more schlock than shock. But one scholar claims there have been about 20 murders in recent years linked to fans of horrorcore.
Well, I'm creeping up behind you, cut you and I blind you, and stick you in the closet in my house that I assigned you. And you ain't got no follow of breath, but every once in a day, I open up my pistol with your head.
The lyrics keep us entertained.
Well, basically, yeah. It's
but they've also apparently given people ideas.
That's because some people are weak-minded.
Most of the fans we saw were young people in their 20s out to have fun. There were some teenagers. Alina Lacunza is 10 years old.
Do you worry about bringing a young child in here? There's a lot of rather explicit lyrics.
It's more about, love. It has nothing to do with violence. Even though they sing about it, it's... There's, I don't know. I just love them.
Monitor what your kids do. You know, I'm in my kids' lives every day.
Mars maintains he has no responsibility when others take his music seriously enough to kill.
How do you know these kids ain't killing because they're on drugs, not listening to my music? I think that's something that needs to be, you know.
But these guys were horrorcore fans.
Yeah, they were horrorcore fans. You know, Charles Manson was a Beatles fan. You know what I mean? Beatles didn't get all that because of Charles Manson, did they? You know what I mean?
So parents should have their kids stop listening to the Beatles.
I'll definitely stop listening to the Beatles and buy my album.
If I do too much, close my crew, we found out.
You're disturbing your head, anything will set you off anyway, so it doesn't matter that there's a horrorcore song. Like, I hear Clay Aiken sometimes and I want to kill people.
What would you say to a parent?
Man, I would say, don't lie to your kids, be honest.
Horrorcore artist Kung Fu Vampire of San Jose has been voted one of the best bands in the Silicon Valley for 3 years running.
Kids are committing murders, and there's a music that is talking about murders. Do you have some responsibility?
I mean, I feel like I don't, because psycho people relate to psycho stuff.
I'm a blinder, blinder.
It's just like the news. You showcase everything from mass murders to just the craziest stuff. So to me, you guys are the granddaddies of horrorcore.
And we can't argue completely with what he's saying, but that's a whole different subject. You know, Mars brought about Helter Skelter.
Right.
And that whole phenomenon that happened during the Beatles era. And certainly there's been violence from rap concerts and rap music and gangs
right.
and all
you
that stuff.
20 years back. And it's
they don't have a corner on it. It just seems like kids are really taking heart in this.
They've taken it up a notch. And so the question is, do these lyrics give kids ideas they might not have had before? And secondly, how disturbed do you have to be to actually act on those ideas that you never had before and listen to those lyrics and take them to heart and act out a murder? That is, I guess, the core of this. It goes back to parenting. Every one of these artists I talked to, the fans and parents I saw in the crowd said the same thing.
Yeah, well, it was interesting to see the artists sort of be honest about it. And what they were saying was, hey, you know, the mask comes off, I'm just a regular guy and just doing a show here, you know, don't do anything stupid.
Right, and most of those kids, they're suburban kids who probably got back on BART and went home and went to sleep. I mean, really, these were gentle kids, most of them, and there were no incidents except our photographer, Patrick Cedillo, had a beer thrown on him.
Yeah, there is that one element of the audience, so that can be dangerous, and that's not to be made fun of.
Exactly.
All right, Joe Vasquez, thank you.